Hey, Lane, the question of the day, of course, like this day, is the real estate market in Orange County slowing down?
I think if I was able to predict if it was going slowing down or if it was going to increase in value or whatever, like I would be a multi-zillionaire because nobody can really predict what's going to happen in the future. But absolutely, what we can do is we can use what we know now, the information that we have at hand, actual factual stats, right? And then make an educated guess on what we think is going on. But I'm personally, I don't know about you, like we're both like, you know, boots on the ground.
Absolutely.
You know, in the trenches for real estate here in Orange County, I'm not really sensing a slowdown at all. I know other parts of the country are, and I know a lot of headlines that you're going to read for national news might be stating such, but I'm not feeling that right now.
Well, I think we have to realize that a lot of the news media, they want sensationalism, they want drama. So they're waiting. They're just waiting for some indication that the housing market is cool, because that is cooling, because that sells, that gets clicks on their ads, that sure gets eyeballs on the newspapers. So they're waiting for that and wanting it to a certain degree.
Now, why do you think it might not be cooling down? And why do you think we're not feeling that here?
Well, I think as we've talked about in stats even recently, that the inventory is continuing to be lower every month year over year, and the market times less, the prices are stronger. Obviously interest rates are staying low, and prediction for that is, because next year's an election year, pretty much they're saying interest rates are probably going to stay low all the way through next year, because nobody wants that in on their belt, you know, in their as they prepare for an election year. So there, all those things are indicating that where we are now is pretty much going to stay status quo.
Well, let's talk about the inventory and let's talk about market time, because I am holding in my hand Orange County Association of Realtors stats here. So this is for all of Orange County single family detached homes. And let's kick it off with inventory of homes for sale. That's down 40% year over year.
I mean, that's amazing.
Huge number.
40%.
Huge.
Almost half as many houses available to sell.
Yeah, absolutely. And because of the low inventory and the high demand, that means that things are going to be selling relatively quickly still. So days on market to sell. Again, in all of Orange County, some marketplaces are experiencing a lot sooner, but it's 19 days, average days on market. And that's down almost 41%.
Once again, another almost 50% drop in how long these houses are selling. So that just means that we still have a bunch of buyers out there looking and looking, I don't want to say frantically,
yeah,
but really looking intensely, and they're watching every day to see things come on the market. Our buyers are doing the same thing.
Yep.
We're all looking constantly, several times a day.
Yep. And let's also talk about average sales price for Orange County. Again, single family detached Orange County, average price, sales price, excuse me, $1,497,799. So just shy of $1.5 million for the average single family detached.
In all of Orange County.
In all of Orange County, which is up 19% year over year.
Absolutely.
So 20%, like think about it. You can't even get 20% returns on your bank. You can't get 20% returns on
20% return would be a dream.
Yeah. So on anything. So I know a lot of homeowners that have, you know, that maybe didn't have to buy this year or the last year. Even if you had to buy last year, you're doing well. But if you had been a homeowner for the last 10 years or so,
absolutely,
you're doing really, really well right now.
Right. And I think as if right now, if the economy cools a little bit, maybe the job transfers are going to slow down too, even, because that's what's driven a lot of this inventory, as we know, from people moving out of the area to take other jobs.
Yeah.
Plus, we have the millennials coming in, which are now buying, which that was always a question. Are the millennials going to be homeowners or are they going to be renters? And now we're seeing that that group is definitely saying, we're going to be homeowners. So that's putting pressure there. You have downsizing, people moving from bigger homes to smaller homes, but it's just the volume is just not there to support the,
well,
what
a lot
they need.
A lot of the baby boomers now, you know, because housing prices have skyrocketed in value, and maybe they don't have a very large loan or a loan at all on their home, they're able to actually take equity from the house and help their kids, help the millennials,
absolutely,
buy a home. So now we're seeing a lot of that happening as well.
And in other marketplaces, maybe those baby boomers or retirees would be thinking about relocating and selling, and that would create more inventory. But if they're helping families buy houses in the area, chances are they're going to stay.
Yeah.
So that's an element of our marketplace that maybe is not going to create any inventory.
I'm happy you mentioned stay too, because a lot of cities in Orange County, like they have the highest turnover, the longest turnover ratio. So where I think I've read somewhere like in Huntington Beach and Westminster areas, like the turnover ratio is like 17 or 18 years.
Right.
Where like a lot of the other world's like 7 years.
Right. Orange County used to be 7 years.
Yeah. So
and
now
that was like years, several years
so
ago.
Now on not, average, not in, the last in 10 a years. Lot of places of Orange County, like the it's getting longer. It's getting longer. So you're seeing close to 20 years of a turnover ratio, and a lot of that could also be too. Like, I personally probably can't afford to buy my house back, but because I have the equity, I can take money out if I needed to. And I can take advantage of the low interest rates and fix the house up to how I want it. So if I needed an extra room, I'll just build the extra room. If I needed the brand new kitchen, instead of buying the home that's already turnkey with a brand new kitchen, I'm going to fix up my kitchen. I'm going to stay.
Absolutely.
And I'm going to take advantage of my low rates, because basically the monthly payment that I'm personally making, I couldn't rent my house back either for that particular month. So I have the capability of taking on a little bit extra on a monthly payment to make the changes that I want with my own house to stay. So a lot of homeowners, I think, are doing that as well, where they might not be able to afford their house back, but they have equity in their home to utilize on a low interest rate to make it how they want.
Absolutely. And also the inventory, maybe it's self-perpetuating, because think about it, if people don't see options for them to buy because the inventory is so low, if they are wanting to downsize or upsize, then they're reluctant to put their house on the market and be homeless. Yeah. Because how long are they going to wait until that house comes up? And then with the flurry of buyers, how they're going to be competing. So that uncertainty probably is creating low inventory.
So will this change? Will this start to cool? Because it hasn't cooled for us. Yeah, one stat that I haven't mentioned yet that I really like to utilize, because it gives us a really good indication if we're in a buyer's or seller's market, it's the month's supply of inventory. Because historically, if we were in a buyer's market, we'd have more than 5-6 months supply of inventory. Historically, if we're in a seller's market, we'd have less than 4 months supply of inventory. That 4 to 5, maybe 6 months supply has always been considered neutral. And basically what month supply of inventory means, if no new listings came to the market, how long would it take to sell off that current supply? Well, in Orange County for last month, it was 1.3.
Right, so we're 4 times below what was considered an average seller's market.
Let's be nice. Let's say it's 4 is neutral. It's like three times, right? Yeah. So we still have to have inventory triple overnight to be considered a neutral market, not even a buyer's market.
Right.
So I think that like we're getting so used to home selling within the first weekend, we're getting so used to multiple offers and getting bid up, that if that changes, the narrative in the news and the headlines are going to be, oh no, things are starting to cool down, which is fine. A cooling is probably healthy for the market, but does that mean that home prices are going to depreciate in value? Does that mean that they're going to crash? Not yet.
No.
Probably not. You're going to have a ton of inventory. And where's that inventory going to come from? Orange County is, like in a lot of areas, for the most part, built out. They're not building all these new, like maybe in some like areas like Rancho Mission Viejo, they're still building some new stuff. But like for the most part, you don't see these huge projects happening. So we don't have the luxury of new home builds like some of the other areas in the country are.
Luxury or competition.
Yeah.
I mean, in some areas, that's why the existing inventory is stagnant, because there is all this competition with the new development. And if you look at the price point of the new development in Orange County, it's not affordable for a lot of people.
So if all of us here refied because of the new rates, if you had a loan, you refied, or maybe like in my case, refied more than once, and you now have a rate in the twos, your monthly payment is awesome, right? Like I personally right now, because I know that the house that I'm in, I know for a lot of people that are living in their homes, it's a long-term thing. I don't care what the value of my home is doing behind the scenes right now, because I can't match that monthly payment anywhere else, even if it was a rental. So I'm personally going to be staying in my home for a long period of time, because one, I love it. But two, I was able to set myself up when the rates went low with a very healthy monthly payment that was very comfortable for my lifestyle. So even if like the home prices for me depreciate 20% overnight, I don't care about that, because I'm not looking to sell. But my monthly payment is still very comfortable for the way that I want to live, that it's going to be making those monthly payments are going to be fine. I know a lot of other people in Orange County that were able to take advantage of these low interest rates are feeling that same comfort, that they might not care as much if there was a correction in price, because they set themselves up on a very low monthly payment, and that's going to keep them in their homes.
Absolutely. But one other thing that we haven't talked about, I mean, we were talking about low inventory and all that, it is definitely a great time to sell. It definitely, if you don't have to worry about some of the things we're talking about, if you have another place to go, if you're moving out of the area or downsizing to something that's more affordable, then it is a great time. This is the time to sell.
The fact that the month supply of inventory is in the ones is ridiculous. And I know Warren Buffett always has the same saying, whatever somebody else is doing, do the opposite of. So if everybody right now is selling, you want to be a buyer. if everybody right now is buying, you want to be a seller. Right now, the demand is outweighing the supply heavily. So if you know that you're going to be selling soon, then you want to take advantage of that and be a seller in this particular marketplace. Because, you know, like it could stay like this for a little bit, but it might not. Like, I would rather be 6 months early than 6 months late on a seller's market.
Well, the prediction of the top of the market is no one has a crystal ball. And we all know historically when you realize what the peak of the market is, it's behind you.
Yeah.
Because you're already seeing it change the other direction. So there are very few people that hit the peak of the market ever, no matter what.
It's practically impossible.
It is impossible.
It's practically impossible. But yeah, hopefully a little bit of insight of what we're feeling and some of the stats we're presenting, hopefully that helped you. You know, we don't want you to freak out if you see a headline that things are cooling, because we're not really experiencing that right now. The stats certainly aren't showing that. And actually, a little bit of a cooling would be healthy for our particular marketplace, because it's been very frustrating for a lot of our buyers that are like getting outbid by very high prices in a competitive marketplace, so that might ease up for them, which would be
some of the offers our sellers are getting are bringing them to tears.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. But we want to hear from you. What are you experiencing? What are you seeing? Are we right? Are we wrong? It's a healthy conversation. Let us know in the comments. But thank you so much for watching. We love bringing this relevant content.
Absolutely.
Orange County Real Estate Beat. We love it.
We live it and breathe it.
We live and breathe it. And we'll be back next week.